Well, I see it on your screen. Hey, that's my face in the thumbnail. I just realized. Excuse me. Well, I hope I don't infect you. Because apparently I'm still coughing up stuff right now.
Oh. Starting. There we go.
All right, so everyone, welcome.
Hey, welcome everybody.
We are doing my first game stream, I think, on PCWorld. I feel like?
Yeah, that probably sounds right.
Yeah.
And luckily, it's a sequel to one of your favorite games of all time,
yes.
Correct?
Not all time, but it's definitely up among the top.
Nice. Well, Alaina and Adam here with PC World. Welcome, everybody.
Hello.
We are going to be streaming Ori and the Will of the Wisps.
And I am playing on controller, so you're going to have to deal with it, Gordon.
She's playing on controller. We're playing on the HP Omen Obelisk with a 2080 Ti and a 9900K, so...
Way overkill for this game.
I don't know. I've heard there's been some performance problems, so, yeah, we'll see.
I don't think it's related to the hardware.
No, yeah, to the game. But interestingly enough, and I don't know how to troubleshoot that or didn't have the time, GeForce Experience isn't doing the frame counter overlay, so... Yeah, I don't know why.
Do you want to do Steam? The Steam one and stuff?
Oh, is there... Oh, yeah, let's do that. Do you know how to set it up?
Yeah, I can't remember off the top of my head.
So, all right, if anybody knows in the chat how to get the Steam one up, we'll do that. But in the meantime... Let's just start and...
I just want to play.
And you haven't, you actually haven't fired this up yet.
Nope. I have Game Pass, so I was planning to start it this week. I have yet to download it. Oh, we're playing at 4K. Nice.
We are playing in 4K 60. Yeah, okay. Boy. Kevin would like a quick explanation of the game.
It is... In a nutshell, a sequel to Ori and the Blind Forest, which came out...
2005?
No, 2015, I think, maybe?
I'm
2016?
Sorry, 2015.
And it's a Metroidvania-style platformer. So that means that, you know, you go through and some areas have things that aren't fully unlocked, so you come back to it later. It's a beautiful game. Super beautiful game.
I've only played a little bit of the first one, so I'm kind of a noob. I got on the Switch, but yeah, so I didn't. It didn't hold my interest.
I got a buddy.
Yeah, you have a buddy at the beginning of the other one. He's kind of a big guy, and then he dies, right? And then you leave.
Spoilers.
Oh well, it just happens to me.
The opening for Ori is about as soul-crushing, in a good way, but as soul-crushing as the opening for Finding Nemo, and I'll leave it at that.
And yes, this is on normal Game Pass and PC Game Pass, correct?
I have not checked that. I play primarily on Xbox. Yes, I know. I just admitted that publicly. So all I cared was whether or not I would have access to it on Xbox One, and I think I should.
I'm checking right now.
It's a baby.
Yep, it's on the on console or PC with the Xbox Game Pass. So yep, I actually purchased the Steam version. She's playing on my account.
It's so cute.
Oh okay. Whenever you get a second, somebody has an easy way to get to the frame counter.
Okay. Oh my god. My heart.
Oh, there's that guy. So I guess he's not dead. Spoilers.
Oh my gosh. So cute. Look at the little art in the back.
Is the owl and this circle thing new characters, or did they show up in the first one?
The owl, the baby owl, is a new character. I haven't played this game probably in about 2 to 3 years, and I can't remember who the spidery guy is. I remember, I feel like I've met them in the first game, but I really have a bad memory for these things now if I don't play, like if it's not in recent memory, or if I haven't played it multiple times over.
So everyone on the stream, let me know if it's looking and sounding okay.
Oh my gosh.
Looking good on my end, so.
This is a beautiful game. It just...
And yeah, if you got a second, if you go to...
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, go to the Steam overlay, so just to
what's the
Xbox. I think that'll bring it up, too.
No. Yes. Okay.
Oh, no, that brings up...
No.
Yeah. What is the Steam overlay? Jeez.
Is it Control Spacebar? I forget.
Da, 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 da. It is Shift Tab.
Shift Tab.
So
okay.
Shift Tab settings down at the bottom. Yeah, right next to web browser music settings. And then in-game FPS counter toggle.
Where would you like it?
Top left, yeah.
High contrast color.
Do it.
Done.
And then Shift Tab again.
Yep. All right. Thanks, stream.
Thank you. All right, well...
Like I said, I don't think our hardware is going to be the issue here.
Yeah, no, I was listening to a podcast, and they were talking about some technical difficulties on the Xbox and on PC as well.
He's kind of, or she, or it's going to fly for the... Oh, you can do it, little buddy.
Yeah, and we even have VSync off. I'm not even seeing any screen tearing.
Oh my god, my heart, everybody. My heart. Yeah, it's really smooth.
So what did you love about the first one? Is that it was like a pretty Super Metroid, is that why?
It's more than that. I think they did a good job of weaving in an emotional aspect to it, in my opinion. Mm. And I thought the gameplay mechanics were, you know, basically quite sound. A couple of little, like, things here and there, but nothing so bad that you would, you know, it would degrade the experience of playing the game. And in some ways, it's pretty challenging. I didn't think it was... I didn't play it on hard. I played it on normal. I'm guessing if I had played it on hard, I would find it a little less, no big deal. But usually when I play games, I try to play them on normal because I feel like that's the experience I want most people to get. Mm-hmm. There are some game series now that I do have to adjust because I know they've kind of, for lack of a better term, watered it down a little bit because they want it to be more appealing to the masses in general. But I think that's just a habit I have left over from when I was doing video game reviews, that you kind of want to, like, my opinion is, like, you want to take the game at the set level that they're trying to say that everyone should play at, right?
Which is why it was always weird that Halo would do, they would have a normal, and then they would have the next one that's hard, and it says the way Halo's meant to be played. Mm-hmm. It's like, well, then why not make that normal?
Yeah, I know.
That never made sense.
I know.
Also, I think that was just like a posturing kind of thing.
What happened?
He broke his wing. This is pretty.
I'm so sad. Oh, I think maybe it had trouble flying and now it's sad. I was talking. I wasn't paying attention. All right.
Yeah, you gotta go console your owl friend.
Console.
Console.
You've been talking too much too about consoles. Speaking of, I'm really wondering what's gonna happen with announcements now that E3's canceled.
You know, yeah.
Hey, where did Curl go?
E3, if you hadn't heard, just got officially canceled.
Bigger. Grew.
I mean, we know Microsoft and Sony were going to do their own streams anyway, you know, around that same time period, but it's not really going to impact them too much. I don't know. I'm more concerned if hardware gets pushed back, or maybe it's just in, like, super limited quantity. Also, I was hearing that some game studios who outsource a lot of development work to China,
mm-hmm.
we might see some major delays from games as well. So,
kind of expected, I guess.
Yeah, Ziv loves the music and the art direction.
Yeah, that too. The music, the art, it's... I think it just comes together in a way that... to me, this is where things, where video games start bordering on art. You know, we like to talk about... Hello. What's going on? All right. Nope. Can I jump in the water? I bet I can.
I will say, on the Steam version, there wasn't really too much in the way of settings, which is kind of a bummer. You always like to see graphical options on a PC version, but...
I mean, what are you really going to set, though, on a game like this? Indie games really...
Yeah, I mean, you're only, like, you have resolution and then resolution scale, but, you know, say you're on a low-budget system and you want to be able to play.
Okay.
Especially a platformer like this, I feel like people really want to lock in a smooth experience, so being able to give people the tools to do that. But then again, with it being such a stylistic game, I could see them wanting to really control how it looks, so I can see both sides of it.
Found a thing.
Spike Blighty says they've been playing it. Best they've played in a long time, platformer-wise.
Did they play the first one? I'm kind of curious if this is just seems like a continuation of the same. Because I haven't read the reviews because I'm trying to, preserve my impression of it some. But so far, this feels very similar to the first game in terms of handling mechanics. One thing I will say that I like about this, so I know that most PC games, they're still designed to accommodate a controller, but not all of them feel exactly the same on controller as they do on console.
Mm-hmm.
Like, sorry, playing it with the controller on PC doesn't always feel the same as playing the same game on console with the controller.
Mm-hmm.
Some people say that they don't find that, but I do. This one feels exactly the same to me. So, for whatever that's worth.
Which is good, especially for a platformer.
Mm-hmm.
Earlier, Dad Isn't Mad said that the owl is so emo now.
I mean, I think I would be too if I was supposed to be able to fly and I couldn't.
And Spike Blighty says that they're new to the series, so they're very impressed so far, but they didn't play the first one.
Aww,
I'm going to go check some settings real quick.
Sure. That's kind of awesome. Oh, I can ride with my friend, my noble steed. Look at this. Oh, that's not going very far, though. Cannot double jump.
Oh, wait, did the first one have a thing where you can partner with somebody?
Nope, this is new.
Huh.
It does not feel as good as I thought it would.
Well, it gives you an extra, like, float?
A little bit.
And Spike Blighty says they're playing on PC with an Xbox 360 gamepad.
Yeah, that's a good one, too. I am playing with an Xbox One controller because that's all I have.
And Leif, friend of the site, Leif Johnson, says Super Meat Boy was one of those games that felt different on PC with a controller.
It does. It really does. Thank you. Thank you for validating my life experiences.
Leif's got your back. And Ziv says it reminds them of...
There's a secret spot here and there's nothing in it for me. Disappointed.
Lame. It's such a secret you can't even find it. Ziv says it reminds them of Beyond Good and Evil. Mm-mm. Man, that's a game that I haven't played in a long time. That was old. Whew. Dad Isn't Mad says, so far the owl's wings are fixed, but now it's going to be your Uber. Also, this episode not brought to you by Clorox and Purell.
Okay, welcome to life in
the most sought after items in San Francisco. Wait, so that tree plays a big part of the first one, too, right?
It's like the spirit of the forest, yeah. Uh-huh. It does, like, the narration.
Isn't that a Japanese thing, too? Like, a forest spirit? It reminds me of Princess Mononoke.
A little bit. I definitely think there's influences of that aesthetic in this game, but it's not Japanese developers. It's actually, I think, a bunch of different developers around the world, primarily based in Europe, I want to say, if I remember right. But yeah, I think it's Moon Studios, right? So they were saying that in some of the early interviews for the first game that they worked remotely on this, which I find fascinating and amazing.
Yeah, I don't even know the needs of game development.
I'm really interested to see, though, what the driving element is behind the plot on this one. Just because the first one had this kind of very profound, kind of almost existential kind of vibe to it, right? Where it's like figuring out this like deep, you know, mystery, solving this kind of, answering this deep question.
Yeah, I found it to be almost a little, almost kind of dark.
A little bit. There's a little bit of that tinge of, you know, this is what real life is. It's not all just beauty. Mm-hmm. Maybe we're getting there with this. You know, normally, I don't know if it's because we're talking, we're hanging out, but normally this number of cutscenes would annoy me. But
this
is actually a lot longer
of an opening segment than the first one.
But I'm actually enjoying this a bit. It feels a little bit more like watching a movie with friends, so I think maybe that's part of it. Oh no. Maybe that's what makes it more enjoyable. No! Oh, this is gonna be me. We gotta find each other.
Epic.
This is a very long, long, winding intro.
Everybody's loving it, though.
Boy. Is that a cat? Look! That's a kitty! It's multiple.
Yeah, it's almost like a cross between a cat and a meerkat.
Yeah. Oh, cute noises. Boy, you gotta find your friend.
I wonder if this game supports HDR, because, man, I can imagine this on
this
HDR.
This would look amazing in HDR.
Leif continues up and says, when a game captures that feeling that well, I find it's really hard to recapture that in a sequel. Mm. Like, imagine a sequel to Journey. Nah.
Yeah. I think I'm okay with thinking of this as a kind of a tacked-on story, so to speak, not like a true sequel. Okay, we finally started the real game now, because, you know, I have my meter and all of that. I kind of find that... I think of it... So, this is going to date me. But Ocarina of Time versus Majora's Mask.
Well, I mean, but those were such different... I mean...
They're very different games.
Boy, yeah.
Ow.
I mean, even the mechanics were so different.
Right, but what I'm saying is that it's kind of a continuation, right? So you get to stay in that world, but it's such a different game. You don't think of it as lesser than Ocarina of Time. It's just a different... It's almost like reading side stories in a universe as opposed to reading a true sequel in the series. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now I've got that. Okay,
wait. It sounds like this does support HDR. We don't have an HDR monitor. But yeah, I bet this looks good on HDR. In something like this, obviously you just barely started, but because it's essentially a continuation of a story, would you recommend people go back and play the first one?
Not paying attention.
What? Do you ever think of that?
Sorry, what?
That it's probably one of those games that you need to go back and play the first one?
No, I don't think it's quite that experience. But I think how do I put this? I love the first game so much that until I finish playing the second one, I don't know if I would say that this just can substitute for the first one. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
If you want to just start with this one. I don't think you'll be disappointed. But I don't think it has it. Right, so far, it doesn't have the same impact that first one had. It's just so different. Like, as I said, you know, when you have the whole Finding Nemo emotional experience. versus, you know, maybe something else. What do I want to do?
Both Ziv and Dead Isn't Mad think that Ori looks like Mew, the Pokemon Mew.
A little bit.
Oh, yeah, an OLED screen. I bet this looks
really yeah, good. That would look really good. So I don't have any attacks yet.
Right now, to pair with my eGPU at home, Gordon let me borrow the Dell XPS that has the OLED screen on it. So
come on,
I'll have to try it out.
Can't do this. What's wrong with you?
I don't think that XPS has HDR. Dell XPS.
Nope. Oh,
15,
oh. What is wrong with you, Alaina?
HDR. So yeah, when you die, you get transported back to one of those little resurrection stone things, right? Is that correct?
I don't remember, honestly.
Or is it, because it's not, you're not like finding like a save room, like a Castlevania or something, right?
Again, I don't remember this game very well.
Oh.
I think you do have to save at certain points, or it might auto-save at certain points. I want one of those. Oh, this is hard, trying to, like, talk and play at the same time. This is not my normal. I love playing games because it's quiet. And I get to think on my own. There we go.
Dell does not have HDR, but it's DCI-P3. 100% DCI-P3. OLED.
Yeah, I'm kind of... I've always been very impressed by streamers who can just play and talk at the same time, nonstop.
It's skill.
I do not have such skill. At least not yet. And if you weren't here, I think it'd be even more difficult.
Ployth9000 says waiting on their 10980XE to get here. PC build is done, just can't game without a CPU.
Oh, right, I forgot about this.
Spike Blighty says that they think that this game is like a Disney version of Knight Stories, K-N-Y-T-T, a lesser-known indie platform. I've never heard of that. Have you heard of that?
No.
Let me look this up.
I've been very bad, though, about keeping up with the video game scene. You know, it's both a blessing and a curse. I feel that we have such a bounty of games now.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, it's obviously a blessing because you have all this choice, you have all these things you can play. But it's kind of a curse because now it means you miss out on things that you might not have heard of. It's becoming like books. Well, there's so many.
And we're older now, too. There's less time to play everything.
Yep. Thanks for reminding me that I'm older.
It happens. Okay, so Angel says you get resurrected at the last save point.
Yeah.
Also, Dad Isn't Mad wants to know where does the emo owl go?
The what?
Where did the emo owl go?
We got separated. Yeah, there was a storm. We got separated, and now the goal is to find my buddy. Burn.
Jeff says they got themselves a Model O gaming mouse. I don't know what that is.
Burn.
Nice.
Just destroy all the things. I think that means that I just had a save.
Oh, you saw something pop up?
Yeah, I saw a little...
Oh, this is one of those light, says it's the lightest RGB gaming mouse.
Sorry, what?
Just somebody in the chat got this,
Oh, one of the lightweight
mice.
Yeah,
very lightweight. Supposedly it's the lightest weight RGB mouse, according to them. It looks pretty nice.
You're just gonna give me your keystone. Alright, cool. Don't understand it, but I'll accept it. Gotta explore some more because I feel like I missed stuff.
So I have a question for all you ultralight mouse users out there. I would assume that if they went wireless, that would add weight. But I also feel like having the tension of the wire, I've never liked having that tension of the wire, and I've never used one of those little standoff things that programmers use, but I think most lightweight gaming mice
I remember this now.
are wired. Let me know if that's true or not. And Angel is asking, are you playing with the Xbox controller?
I am playing with the Xbox One controller. Xbox not the Elite, One. Just the standard Xbox One S controller. So this is the keystone he's talking about. Can I jump up any higher? No. There's something up there, though. And I... Excuse me, just gonna be in here, in your house, attacking you with fire.
Wrecking your stuff. In your house, wrecking your stuff.
Nope, I haven't double jump yet, so I can't get there yet. Same for this. Alright, cool. Actually, watching me play how I normally play would be very boring.
No, take your time. I will say, with those overlay effects with the rain, we're definitely losing a lot of frames. I saw a little bit more tearing.
Yeah? What did we drop to? I wasn't paying attention.
We dropped out to like 80, so about a 40 frame drop. This says you don't feel the tension of the wire with light cords as long as they don't catch.
Makes sense.
Logitech Pro G Wireless. Logitech Pro G Wireless.
Yeah. Destroy all the things with fire.
It's 80 grams.
I have no idea what that means in American freedom units.
And I'm like, is there that much of a difference between 80 and 60? Probably. Leif says it's like breaking pots as Link.
Yes. Yes, yes, it is. Satisfying, too.
And Angel's wondering if Gordon thinks how easy it would be to play this with a mouse and keyboard.
Ooh, you look like a little nasty thing.
Hype-hyphen is asking, can that character grow?
Can Ori get larger, you mean?
Yeah, well, larger or maybe like some sort of RGB stats.
RGB stats.
RPG elements of character growth. I'm not quite sure which one they're saying.
I don't remember the first game. I really should. I mean, you get like attacks and stuff, but I don't... I mean, Ori doesn't literally get larger.
Also, Leif, did you review this back in the day? I'm curious. And Ziv says that you're a pyro, Alaina.
Oh my god, there's a shiny over there. I want it.
School Jackson's asking, why wouldn't they put HDR capabilities in the PC version when the game is also made for the Xbox? I can't find concrete proof that there is no HDR in here.
I lost my torch.
Oh, because you went under the waterfall, yeah.
I'm sad. But now I have a keystone. I guess life's like this. You give some, you take some, and now I can't actually fight monsters, and that's sad. I shouldn't have gone to the water. Dang it.
And Ziv says his RGB stats are through the roof.
His RGB stats are through the roof.
Also, I heard RGB protects you from the coronavirus, so the more RGB you have is good.
Well, I mean, in theory, if you have enough RGB that you're just at home all the time playing on your awesome PC, then yes, then I mean, you would be.
And Leif says he did not review it, but it is one of his favorite games, the first one.
Yeah. Can I come back up if I fall down? There?
Leif, have you started playing this one?
Let's try it. Maybe I shouldn't have made this choice, but I already did it, so committing. Probably should have gone the other way first. Oh, I came this way. Okay.
You know what's funny is that whenever in a video game I'm presented with a choice, I always go left first.
Do you really?
I came up with this idea years ago to be like, all right, if I have a left or right choice, I'm always going to go left first.
I mean, it does simplify. Oh. Does simplify it.
Yeah, then I don't have to like worry like, oh man, did I make the right choice? Like, well, I was offered a choice and I just go left.
Didn't you ever get bored though?
I mean, usually I'll circle back and find out what's to the right later, but, you know.
So I
if I'm not quite sure what
see,
to do.
I just gotta go back, because that guy wants the keystone. Let's get another part. A little bit of life here. Thank you. Yeah, I got that.
Oh, Spike Blighty says that it's a Unity engine game. Don't know if it has RGB capabilities. I am reading just quick Google noosh. Search. It's at least implies era. That there is HDR. Honor me,
era. I don't know what you're like, Mr. Weird Stranger Guy, but I'll take your free stuff.
The parallax scrolling is really nice. I do like that. Leif says he didn't even realize that it was out. He's so out of touch with games these days. He's just basically a regular game player now.
It's a weird feeling. It's a weird feeling to be out of the loop like this. All right, let's talk to you again one more time, because why not?
Do you think he was named after the popular app with all the kids, TikTok?
I wouldn't know, because I'm not in touch with the kids.
You know, all the kids love their TikTok.
I'm still learning how to use the word salty.
Actually, I don't know if you heard, also another thing that just came out was the new Battle Royale mode in Call of Duty Modern Warfare. I was so excited to play it until I found out that there's no solos, and I'm a little bummed. But I do want to try it out.
Where did I get the fire? Can I go back and get more fire? Oh, that doesn't look promising. Ooh, that looks dangerous. I want more fire. No.
Yeah, we're dropping down to the 80s again now that we're in the rain effects.
I forgot where I got the fire. That's what I get for not paying attention. Yeah, let me through. So, Metroidvania-style games are the best and the worst thing for me. Because that hint of, like, something's there that I... Wait, so I'll just show you what I mean. So I can see that there are collectibles up here. There's something happening up here, and I can't get to it yet, and that's... Ooh. I will end up spending, like, 12 hours in this game just so I can come back to that.
Yeah, I think it's funny, because on the Metroidvania, I feel like...
I want my torch!
You fall more on the Metroid side, and I fall more on the Vania side.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure how to explain it, or what that even means, but... It's a weird distinction.
There is a distinction. There is
a distinction. I just don't know how to describe it.
But I think... I kind of like that there's that... Oh, what's happening? Oh. Well, you don't look like you want to be friends.
Chasing.
Oh,
run! Oh.
Ow. I'm dead.
Oh, it's fast loading, at least.
Let's just hide over here. Nope. All right. So, I hate things like this because I can't think fast enough to figure out what's happening. So, obviously, there's got to be
something. Can you go under him?
Yeah, I think I'm going to have to go that way. Bye, dude. Nope.
It's like Super Meat Boy level all of a sudden.
Well, it's not even that, because it's just not obvious to me where I'm supposed to be going.
Can you jump on its nose, maybe, when he dives at you? Or, like, hit him?
I think I just have to get a further start. That's what it is. Like, I'm just taking too long. Earlier start, rather. Bye. Ow. Fire.
Take it in the face.
Nope, that killed me. All right. So I guess I should just keep running.
Probably.
All right, cool.
Zip says, bad doggy.
We'll run your way to fight another day. This kind of reminds me a little bit of, like, this is weird, because the first game wasn't like this, where, like, it was very much more about exploration.
Yeah, this almost feels like a,
Oh, it's like an actual boss battle.
Yeah, he has a little health bar.
I hate this. Like, I just want to explore a game up front. Like, why do I gotta do boss battles?
This reminds me of, like, Lara Croft.
Ow.
Ooh, yes. Leif's talking about Salt and Sanctuary. I have played a fair number of that. That was a really cool game. I did not beat it.
Okay, so I can't let him actually bite at me.
Is there a dodge or a roll?
Probably. I'm really bad at tactical. Y'all have seen my flaws in the gamer immediately.
It's weird. I put in the title "Expert Level Gamer Plays Ori in the
Did
Little
you
Wizard.
Really?
No, I didn't.
Oh my god, what's wrong with you?
No, I didn't.
Good.
Do a barrel roll.
Bad doggy.
Nice. There you go.
Achievement unlocked. Close call. Given that I'm down to
only
one
full. Thanks for getting me achievement.
Do you actually collect achievements?
No. Especially not on Steam.
Yeah, what's happening here? How do I get up? This. What might defeat me now is I can't even figure out how to get out of here. Okay. So that doesn't look like a way I really... can go. Let's go back to all the parts where I was running for my life.
Dad isn't mad. No, I don't have to help her out because she's awesome. She is a pro-level gamer.
Yeah, that's...
She just beat that section.
Stretch. Now, I don't like to ask for help just because... Ah! That's nice. I am stuck... Hello. That was a very Metroid moment.
I missed it.
Just like descending into like whole new like area thing gave me a very strong Metroid vibe right there. And I wish I'd known I was going to do that because I would have liked to have gone down the slow way. Hello, meerkat thing. Goodbye, meerkat thing.
Oh, Mr. Smiles came, gave us $1.99. Thank you. And says Horizon Zero Dawn is coming to PC this summer.
And all the Sony PlayStation fans have been betrayed.
I mean, hopefully there's nobody in the chat. Or if you are, maybe you can help me understand this. But
oh, this is like a special scene.
I literally saw like videos of people like throwing their PS4 down and like breaking it.
I feel like that's got to be staged.
I don't know, because they feel betrayed.
That's
that,
got to be staged. Ooh, am I getting new power? I'm getting new power, everybody.
And I just don't
Look
get it.
Look how beautiful this is. It's so beautiful.
I shared a...
Oh, did it just knock him out?
He's sleepy. I shared a good tweet earlier on our Discord. Sign up for it in the description. Where did I put it? Gaming.
Kuma, that's right. That's somebody, the name of Spider Guy.
I'll wait till this is over.
Oh, you're looking for
Thank you,
friends.
Mr. Smiles Cam.
So I think Leif is right that you can't, you know, capture lightning in a bottle twice, because I just don't feel like this has the same level of poignancy, like that emotional, where it grabbed you and you just like felt all the things. And I don't know if it's because the pacing is different, which it is, or if it's because I already have something I've come to expect.
The pacing is definitely different.
I'm guessing it's a combination of both.
Yeah, I'm trying to think of a couple times where a sequel is better than the original. But yeah, it's like something about it.
Assassin's Creed 2.
You know, I liked the original one.
What? Because
it was unique.
I mean, the second one was better, though.
Well, I know, but like technically, I'm sure this is better, too, in terms of controls and everything, you know. But that first one, which is so unique, and you're just like exploring the world and the idea, was just like, wow, this is so crazy. Where are they going to go with this? So I don't know. I mean, in that case, the first one wasn't mechanically a great game, so they were able to improve upon it. The first one was mechanically a great game, so it's just refining. I mean, there's certain games like I would say.
Yes, I have a weapon.
Silent Hill 1, I loved, and then 2 was just that much better.
Cutting all the grass just like Link.
Terminator 2, but they're also different. I would call Terminator, the original one, a sci-fi movie.
So
the second one.
Shredding grass. Anyway, sorry, cool. I'm listening.
Oh, so Spike Blighty is asking you directly, Alaina, should I stop playing this game and play the first one?
I mean, I would hate to tell anybody they have to stop playing a game they just bought. I do think that if you finish this game first, you may not get the same attachment to the first game as if you played just the first game as your first experience with this world.
Yeah, and it'd probably be harder to play this one and then go back and play the first one.
Yeah, oh boy.
So if you want to play the first one regardless, then you should probably just go play that one. But if you don't think you're ever going to play the first one...
Yeah.
Also, back to the PS4 thing. Somebody had a snarky tweet that I liked. Their Twitter handle was 9volt.
Oh gosh, Alaina, come on.
A sad day for PlayStation fans. A game they played 3 years ago is now on a different platform, which means the experience they had with it 3 years ago is tarnished. This is a betrayal from Sony that PlayStation Nation will never forget.
There's a PlayStation Nation?
Well, I'm sure.
What is it? What are the taxes like living there?
And yes, Ori 1 is on PC.
Oh, so much sacrifice just to get the one orb.
Also, another game that just came out, sound. Technically came out, was Black Mesa, the remake of Half-Life 1. I'm very excited to go back and play
that. Don't die! What's the remake like? Are they adding anything to it?
Yeah, no, it's a complete overhaul, and it's a fan made thing with the blessing of Valve. Also, Leif says Mass Effect 2, no question, but also, I don't know, it's like, yes, Mass Effect 2 is a better game, but I don't know, having that world that, like, oh wow, you can almost recreate a Star Wars video game and not have the Star Wars license, I didn't get that the second time around, because it was like, oh okay, I know what this is, it's Mass Effect, it's Star Wars in a video game.
Dang it. I stopped doing that. Hey. This is why I have to be more...
Get good, Alaina.
I know. Usually I'm more aggressive than that with them, but I was trying to be conservative, and this is what I get for that.
And Bill Willis, yes, this is the new one. It just barely came out. Dad Isn't Mad is asking, if the green orb represents health, what does the blue orbs represent?
If I remember right, that has to do with, like, a powered attacks. But it's been a while.
Can you, like, hold down X to, like, charge up or something?
Possibly? I haven't tried that yet. Nope.
Doesn't look like it.
Yeah, I don't think I'm there yet. It's funny because my first thought is, oh, HP and mana. That's how I think of it as. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, okay, I'll get to use my mana at some point once I actually learn some spells. It's kind of how my brain automatically classifies it. Yes, I will take things from your dead body.
And Michael Hayes says they really like in this music.
Yeah, the music's really great in these games. Oh, another controlled scene. All right, your cat buddies, what's up?
What's that squishing sound?
I guess they're still eating. Great and mossy.
Oh, yeah. New Doom. I keep forgetting the new Doom's coming out.
Oh, the map just appeared.
Spike Bloody says the blue orbs are energy for your bow and other spells.
Yeah. It's a weapons thing.
That's squishing.
Well, that's what happens when you talk with your mouth full. Quest details. So do I just... Okay.
Oh, interesting. Angel said if you hold B, you should be able to save the game and lose a blue point. Like, it almost makes like a save state.
Nope, not yet. I think you have to maybe earn that ability.
Yeah.
I think that was in the first game. I mean, now that I think about it, it sounds familiar. But, okay.
Hold on. And you're right, yeah. Mass Effect is more like Star Trek. You're right.
Yeah. come from here. What's this? What is... Spigate. Check that out in a second.
Oh, a composer named Jareth Coker. Coker? Composed for both the games. He's one of Ziv's favorite composers now.
Hello, we got...
What's
we
up,
got,
Willis?
We got a guest.
What's going on, man?
What's going on, man? Oh, God. I'm distracted.
Yeah.
I'm just killing myself because I can't concentrate on someone coming here.
She's next. We love
to hang out.
She's distracting her. Sorry. How could you?
Oh, I know.
How's lunch? Yeah. Pork chop. No, not really.
I don't know what you are, but you look dangerous. Just gonna tap me in the butt here.
Let me make sure I don't have any messages.
Okay, so keystone there. I want to get another jump thing at some point.
Oh, okay. Yeah, yeah.
So that's close to me for now.
And then, yeah, take off the... Thanks, sir.
Come back. Please. Where have I been? Okay, I just came here because that's where the tree was. It's been a long time. Get him up.
And no, this game does not support ray tracing. Captain Ply.
Bits are really, really beautiful, though. Doo-doo.
It's a really good sound design.
Taking your advice and going left. Except I just...
If you can. Maybe you can.
I don't know if I can.
Yeah, maybe you need to get a double jump.
So close.
Nope. I know, I hate that sometimes when you're like, wait, right. Does it mean I can't yet?
Oh, here we go.
Oh, okay. Or does it mean
actually, if
I can't execute on it?
I'm going to go see what this is all about.
Doom Eternal. Oh, God. How far we are from Doom Eternal? Doom Eternal.
It joins. It heals.
March 20th. So 10 days.
Julianne's, too.
10 days.
Oop. So I won't see you in about 2 weeks.
7 days.
I mean, I guess it's a good thing. Then we might have to endure quarantine at some point. You can just hang out with that game.
Yeah, well, we'll see. For the people at home, just know that videos are probably going to be a little more sparse coming up. We're going to be doing a lot more working from home in the coming future.
Yeah, we're going to try to figure out something, right?
Yeah, we need to do some stuff. I have some plans. I think we can do some stuff.
So much I want to explore.
And we still want to keep up with the full nerd, which I will say, not next week, but the week after that, the new intro will be ready.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so...
It's all new.
Alaina has not seen it, but...
But you filmed it already.
No. We're filming parts of it today after this. And then... Yeah. I'm very excited for that.
Are there going to be... Aw, man. Are there going to be people in it?
I mean, as of right now, what we're going to be filming is mostly the hands. Like last time, I don't want to put anyone recognizable in it, so.
Is that necessary?
Bill Willis says we should set up 3 TVs here in the studio, and then we remote all of you in.
And it's just gonna be you.
That would be hilarious. Or maybe even a 4th TV back, and then just RDP into the.
It's gonna
the
feel
mixing.
Very Futurama-ish, you know, with like the heads, you know. That would be.
I like that. That would be funny. Oh, by the way, Steven says congratulations. It's been like 2 years since you first said you were going to start streaming. And now you're finally doing it.
It's not been 2 years. Year and a half. Dang it. Year and a half.
This isn't even dealing with the project.
No, it's not. Although we actually do have a schedule for finishing that finally.
We do.
It's supposed to happen. I'm not going to say because I don't want to jinx it, but we do.
Especially with
double jump. Finally. I finally have double jump. Oh, man. I'm going to have to play this all over again on my own account.
Yeah.
And it's going to go so much smoother, I hope. Or you'll get a text from me where I'm like, Adam, I can't remember anything.
Send me your save file.
Yes.
Angel is asking, when can we expect Ryzen 4000 laptops? And will there be a delay because of the corona? That is a question that you'd have to ask Gordon.
Mm-hmm.
So let's wait till the next full nerd.
Oh my God, double jump's the best thing in the world.
And why don't you tune into that and ask him, because we're not really privy to that information, so.
Gordon gets all the, I had it, and then I lost it. There you go.
Nice.
All right, let's go explore.
I will say, I'll have to show you after this, I didn't bring it in. I got a new retro handheld gaming emulator.
Ooh, did you?
Yeah, this company reached out to me because I was doing the Pocket Go stuff called Pow Kitty. K-I-D-D-Y, not kitty.
Oh, I was about to say, I got behind in, you know, keeping up with my YouTube subscriptions, and I saw that Steve had done, sorry, I shouldn't pause like that.
Oh,
I keep thinking this is real
stuff.
Life.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I just saw that, and I said, I don't know what that case is, but I have to have it.
Yes. But yes, the Pow Kitty Q90, it has reviewed well, and a lot of people are comparing it to the new Pocket Go. Though, I don't know, at first glance, I haven't necessarily been liking it. It also does, even though it adds a better thumbstick, which the thumbstick on the new Pocket Go is just garbage, it loses the top four triggers. It only has two triggers on the top, so it's a little weird. I don't really want to trade off a better thumbstick for the loss of functionality. So that's kind of a bummer. Also, it's a lot thicker. I mean, it's still pocketable, but it's thicker because it has the nicer thumbstick. And I did fire up a couple games. Like, one of the ones I always like to fire up first is F-Zero, because that's just such a fast-paced game. It didn't run it smooth right out of the box. I mean, I can kind of mess around with the settings a little bit, but... and Charles is asking, can we make the cam bigger for seeing you two? I can, if you would like to.
You really want to see our faces?
And Will L., friend of the show, Will L., thanks for joining us, says they would love for us to do a Doom Eternal stream because they haven't been this genuinely hyped for a game in years. I will guarantee, no matter what form it takes, I will be doing a Doom Eternal stream, even if we're quarantined at home. Because I am super excited about that as well.
So, you have to explain this to me as somebody who isn't a Doom person. What makes Doom Eternal so exciting?
Well, assuming that it's like Doom 2016, which, you know, from everything I've seen, it is, the gameplay is just so fast-paced and smooth, and traditional first-person shooters are usually not as mobile as Doom, and I don't necessarily mean that in, like, double-jumping and mobility of your character, but, like, how fast you can whip around environments and how fast you're changing weapons and doing a bunch of different things, like the... Those glory kills, I think, is what they're called. You just felt so powerful. You just felt so, just whipping around the scene, just, you know. And there's different ways to there's so many different ways to encounter or deal with the encounters that you come across. I remember back in the Halo days, you know, the peak of Halo, a lot of people were talking about, like, encounters and like how unique each encounter is and how you can approach encounters in so many different ways. Yes, I mean, to a certain degree, more than like a Call of Duty, but I tell you what, when it comes to Doom, I feel like that's the pinnacle.
Where to next? That is
awesome.
Oh, let's see.
Personally, that's what I love about it.
Right.
Leif says he wrote so much about the 2016 Doom for Vice. It was really good because it managed to capture the feel of the original games while looking like a modern game.
Okay.
Good point, too. Good, good.
I think I've been here before. Yes.
Dad Isn't Mad is asking, do we have a good idea whether Stadia is worth it or not? I had a friend who doesn't have a PC want to play Doom Eternal on Stadia. Well, assuming that Doom Eternal comes out on Stadia, day and date. I'm not quite sure about that. I still would be hard pressed to recommend Stadia to anybody, especially without a free option. Also, because it's Bethesda, unfortunately, they pulled almost all their games off of GeForce Now, because that's what I would recommend. You buy it on Steam, they buy it on Steam so that they always have it, and then just play it on GeForce Now, but I think we gotta cross our fingers, because there is one Bethesda game, which is the newest Wolfenstein, that is on GeForce Now, so I'm hoping maybe, because this is the new one, that they work something out, because, yeah, if that's the case, GeForce Now is definitely the way to go. But hey, I mean, if they don't have a gaming PC and they also don't have a console, I mean, I would still pick a console over a gaming PC.
Yes.
Yes, me too.
That was a very satisfying bit of platforming. All the keystones. All right, what have I explored? I'm going to see what's up here at some point, but for now, onward. Okay, that doesn't look healthy. I kind of like how pink is a bad color in this game.
And Bill Willis, yes. So the idea with GeForce Now is that you're just signing into your Steam and Epic libraries on a computer in the cloud and then streaming it. The problem is it only supports certain games because of deals with publishers. So I'm just, yeah, really hoping that Doom Eternal comes out on GeForce Now, because I think that would be really a really good get for them.
Oh, that music change. It's nice. Does anyone remember the original Rayman? I love the music in that. This kind of reminds me a little bit of that.
I was never a Rayman fan.
What?
Yeah.
Get out.
Sorry.
Just get out.
And Ziv is bringing out. Up Shadow. Yeah, actually, Brad, I think it was just today on PCWorld.com, Brad did a hands-on of Shadow, or maybe just a news posting. Let's see. Let's see if I can find it. Huh. Huh, maybe he didn't. I could have swore he did a post about Shadow.
Might not have been gone. It might not have gone live yet.
Yeah, I've not looked into. Obviously, there are some reports of it being good, but I have not looked into that one.
Up. Do I want to keep climbing back up? I think I want to go here.
Yeah, unfortunately, I don't think any of them are perfect yet. And yes, actually, because I've moved, I haven't hooked up my Nvidia Shield in my new place. But yeah, GeForce Now and Nvidia Shield, I'm sure, is great. Or I haven't used GeForce Now since it came out officially.
Just came through here.
I used it a lot back in the beta period.
As you all are finding out, I do not have a good sense of spatial orientation.
Ziv says, I'm a big Raving Rabbids fan, though they hijacked Rayman series a bit.
They did. Funny. But.
And Daniel says, they beat Rayman Legends. It was a real fun in co-op.
Rayman Legends is a great game. I'm actually talking about the very first game ever that came out. So I think it came out like in 95? Oh. Sorry, Ori. This is what happens when I try to talk and play at the same time. So it came out like in 95. It was like on PlayStation and PC. Hard, super hard game. But just had the most beautiful music, in my opinion. And I thought they did a great job of when they brought back the franchise in Rayman Origins and then later Rayman Legends, of staying true to that while making it much more accessible to a modern audience.
You know what I realized? Maybe it's because I'm not...
You're not a platformer.
I'm not a platformer.
You're
No,
you don't like platformers.
Yeah, I was never a platformer, where Castlevania is a little less about the platforming and more about the action and RPG elements.
And that's probably why you like it better.
So that's
why.
Because
I like the platforming aspects. Mm-hmm.
Maybe that's where it is.
That's where I had to go. Oh my gosh, come on.
Wait, is this where you fought the...
Yeah, this is where I fought the wolf guy. Let's see if I can do this. There we go. And this is the one thing I want to say about this game that's very satisfying as someone who plays a lot of platformers, where, I mean, when you time your jumps right, it works right. You know, like, here, I'll show you that again. Let go. Okay, so if I... So I have to kind of hold it and then wait and then jump again. Some games, when the mechanics aren't nice and tight like that, it doesn't work, and it drives me crazy, because that's how it should work. It's a very satisfying feeling.
Also, I'll point out something that I haven't officially confirmed, but I heard it on a podcast from the Giant Bomb crew, is that the original Ori characters animated at 30 frames a second. That's what they had, did the frames animation for, but this one is 60. So a lot more smoother frames of animation. And CC says, how could you not like Yoshi's Island? I actually never played Yoshi's Island. Did you play Yoshi's Island?
I don't recall.
Wasn't that Super Mario World 2?
Yeah, that's like Super Nintendo game.
Yeah, Super Nintendo.
I did not play that one. I wanted to, but I couldn't afford it at the time that I wanted to play it. Where am I trying to go from here?
Can you hold on to it and swing?
Maybe. Let me see.
You know what's funny, Spike the Blighty? You bring up Bloodstained. I did back Bloodstained. Very big Koji Igarashi fan. It didn't grab me the way I wanted to. I don't know. I think it was the... I've always been a fan of like the Dracula mythos and all the imagery and the music and what they had built up around Castlevania, but...
No.
Yeah, Bloodstained didn't get me the same way, unfortunately, so I'm a little bummed by that. I bought it multiple times because I was like, maybe I'll play it on Switch, maybe I'll play it on PC, maybe I'll play it somewhere else, but yeah, I unfortunately never got into it. I need to keep giving it more shots. Super Mario RPG, Ziv, great game. I played the hell out of that one. This might have been the first RPG that I ever beat, personally.
Alright.
Also, Ziv, you just outed yourself as a console fan. I'm going to tell Gordon, and he's going to take you where your PC card, sorry.
Yeah, give back that shirt.
Yeah, sorry. Once he finds out, you're going to have to...
Sticky. Oh, gosh, what's going on with my glasses?
Wait, sticky? Does that mean you can actually just climb up walls, or
it means that you kind of stick. You kind of stick onto it a little bit. So I guess I have to set it. Didn't know I had to do that. Thought it was automatic.
Maybe it is a grab.
Yeah. All right. What do I got here? And
that's a lot of holes in that tree. What's that thing where you're scared of, like something with a lot of holes?
Oh, I don't remember.
Tryptophobia.
Is that what it's called? Something is not fitting right with these headphones. I think they are sized.
Oh, yeah, it is.
Someone with a different
size. It's an extreme apprehension of the following things, which brings an all-over irritating feeling and general easiness. Tryptophobia is a pathological fear of holes, especially irregular cluster of holes.
Okay, that's
what that made me think of.
Oh, yeah, so the iMac or the Mac Pro. Okay, so yeah, how does this sticky thing work?
Like says, it probably helps with timed jumps.
Well, let me just see if I can find something I can stick to.
Yeah, maybe that wall there.
Yeah, let's see.
Okay.
Oh, like I just stick
go.
To it.
Yeah, you just
All right,
stick.
Here we go.
But it looks like it's using your blue points.
Does it?
Or no, I don't know, I couldn't tell.
No, let's not waste it on experiments. Let's...
Oh no, I guess it doesn't.
Nope. You would think?
Wait, so what's down there in the middle between those two poles?
Just spikes.
And yes, that is a literal skill tree.
See, spikes. Nope, that doesn't seem
Can
to...
Can you grab onto this wall?
Maybe.
No, I guess not.
It doesn't really matter, though.
Well, is there a wall maybe just more to the right?
Oh, yeah. Good point. Nope.
Oh, no.
That's spiky, too.
Definitely not.
I
want to
get up there. Maybe I just can't go this way right now. Maybe I just can't go this way. But I want to go this way. I have to go this way eventually.
They got you.
They did. Alright, well, I'll get that back. I do think it's weird that I had to equip, the sticky thing.
Well, that probably just means that you'll have limited...
Yeah, I'm not a big fan of that.
Yeah.
Not a big fan. You would think I could swing this.
And you can't reach those little things up here?
I'm gonna try, but the jump doesn't look like it's gonna happen.
And Bug Lover's text here. Hello. The art style is beautiful. Wow. Is what they say.
I want to go all the way back. What do I want to do now? About the same.
It's funny, every time you cross some sort of line, it autosave.
Yeah, that's the autosave point. Just, I feel like there's got to be something with here, but I'm guessing I need another skill or something to make use of it. So I think I'm going to go back for now. Might be getting this completely wrong, but it's fine. That's how it works in games like this anyway. Give them things, huh? Okay.
Oh, you can repair something.
Okay.
Maybe read in the description. Maybe it's a clue to...
The ore,
for
you
the
mean?
Item, yeah.
Oh, no, it just means that I think if I come across something that needs repairing, like I have the element for
and
it.
And there was nothing that...
Let's find out.
It doesn't say.
It doesn't say anything.
What if you hit Y? What does that do? Oh, there we go.
Energy cell fragment. Oh, I think I'm going to want that. Oh, I'm guessing that's what I would get to if I could go to the top.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to have to wait. It's like a Metroid when you get the energy tanks. Oh, there's a breakable floor down here. All right, maybe I'll try that.
A... Metroidvania that I loved was,
Wait.
Oh, what is it? It was all made by one guy. It was futuristic. The guy had a gun. Or a laser. What was... Oh, man. I hate trying to remember names. Axiom Verge, yes. And they're coming out with a second one. I loved Axiom Verge. Almost beat it. I don't think I ever did.
What was it about?
Oh, wow. He was a scientist, I believe, and he... Excuse me, some experiments went wrong. And it was like, it was very science, very, like, tech. And your gun, like, could upgrade. I believe he was actually in a lab coat, too. It was really cool.
I go down here.
I liked that game a lot.
Did you finish it?
I can't remember if I did. I don't think I fully finished it. I did get pretty far. I It was all made by one guy, I believe. And
I always find that so impressive.
The music was very 8-bit.
And someone like does the whole game on their own.
Yeah. Yeah, he's making a sequel. Very excited about that. Angel says on the Xbox stream they confirmed that Ori is a Play Anywhere title. So if you buy it on the Microsoft Store, you get it on Windows and Xbox.
Yeah, I think earlier the question was we weren't sure if it was included for Game Pass for PC, but I'm guessing if it's a Play Anywhere title, it would be.
Yeah.
Okay, so is this the breakable wall? This must be. But I don't have the ability to break it yet. Yeah. All right, fine. I will go. Can I mark things? Nope. All right, I'm gonna go backwards and see if I can get anywhere. Otherwise, I'm just going to call it a day. How long have we been playing?
70 minutes.
Yeah.
So yeah, we can stop whenever. And Leif says, Alaina might like it because it looked a lot like Metroid.
Oh, yeah?
But I would say it's more on the Castlevania side gameplay-wise. Mm. I wouldn't... A lot more shooting than platforming.
Yeah, I like the platform.
Which is probably why I liked it.
Yeah. I'm going backwards. Nope, I'm not going backwards. I'm going the wrong damn way.
You're going the wrong way. Is it in the Game Pass? This game is in Game Pass. I don't know if Axiom Verge is.
This makes me actually really excited to go home and play this, except I can't do it tonight because I am an adult and I have things I have to do tonight.
I don't think it is.
Is Doom Eternal, right?
Yes.
The game, next game. Oh, God dang it. What you're looking forward to next? Anything else?
I really do want to try that Call of Duty Battle Royale. I'd be curious to see if Leif tries it or not. But I've actually been playing Divinity Original Sin 2.
Really?
Yeah, because I had it on PC because I knew I wanted to play it.
That was dumb.
Ooh. And then I actually picked it up on the Switch because it has crossplay. And I can play it on the bus, get to work, upload the save to the cloud, and I've done it a couple times and it's worked really well actually.
This is where I want games to go.
Like, I know, right?
If it's a multi-platform game, don't lock me out between platforms.
Well, but all those PlayStation fans just feel threatened over their games coming everywhere.
They're going to have to get rid of their, get back up. Let's go around.
Bug Lovers Tech says, this does seem like one of those games you get lost in a lot. I'll be getting it for sure.
Yeah, I mean, it's lost in a good way, you know. It's not so much about a linear journey. You can kind of, you can emotionally lose yourself in it as well. The mechanics are very satisfying in this game. Like, this is the kind of feel I want in my platformers. Okay. So
Oh, it looks like there was part of the map that hadn't been shaded in.
Yeah, so this is where I came from. I think when I was running away from what's-his-face. Big bad wolf.
Oh, Leif says that he gave Divinity Original Sin 2 the highest score he ever gave a game, he believes.
Really? What was that? 9.5? 9.75?
98. Just kidding, I don't
know. Possible.
647.
I think IGN still does 100 point scale? I don't remember anymore. Ooh. Hello.
Yeah, I have Ori on the first, or the first Ori on Switch. I don't think they've announced the second one coming to the Switch yet.
I think you should finish it. It's a good game.
Okay. I'm just not good at platforming.
That's true.
Like I feel bad because Hayden gave the game of the year 2 years ago to what's that platform with the girl?
Girl.
Goodness, it's one name. I can't remember. It was gave it his game of the year, and he's like, "You should totally try this out." And it was a really awesome game, but it was like definitely a little bit more along the lines of like Super Meat Boy. And I was just like, "I'm just not good at this."
But here's the thing: if you never play platformers, you can't get better at them.
Yeah, I've got other stuff to play.
No, I get it. I get it. I'm just saying, if you
not Catherine. That's a different game.
Celeste.
Yes, that's what it was. Leif says 9.6 out of 10.
9.6. And I want that shard. Okay, let's see. I want to go up, I think, because that's what I haven't explored.
Celeste, yes, I got around to it. Thank you, Leif.
That's not what I thought it was.
Yeah, Steve is saying all you had to say was meat boy like.
Oh.
Yeah, it was. Here we go. It was really hard.
Something new. Look at this scene. Isn't that beautiful? Oh, I love this so much.
Yeah, I wish we had a better monitor to game on. This is just a basic Dell 4K. It's the only 4K monitor we have in the office that we can use for this. So
gorgeous, though.
I did reach out, I think it was Asus reached out to me about maybe getting an ROG 4K one that we could use for gameplay streams. So that'd be nice to upgrade.
So beautiful. Look at this.
Even got God rays and everything. Lupo. Manush.
Ugh, a map maker. You're my new friend. Honey. Jin Shelo. Ah, Inazuko. Yeah, sure, why not?
I don't know. You should look for a better deal. Check camel. See if the prices go down. Do you like it in games when you can haggle price? Like at Witcher 3, you can do that?
No.
No? I thought you would.
No, because it... Ooh.
Whoa.
Yeah. No, because the thing is that I get so caught up in that, then I don't get anything else done. It just adds a little too much for me to work with. All right, so I still want to get here somehow. But there's all of this to explore. Okay, I'm really excited now. I'm really excited. Although,
yeah, that just opened up. Wow.
It did. I don't know if this maybe is a good place to stop.
I think
because,
this is a great place to stop.
Because I should get back to work, even though I would totally play for another 4 hours.
Yeah, right?
On your account. And then I have to go home and do it all over again on mine.
Yeah, right?
Oh, I'm so excited for this, though. Tomorrow night, it's going to be me and this game. And, oh, it's going to be so good. I'm very excited. I'm going to have such repetitive stress injury type things to worry about come the weekend.
Yeah, and you have Game Pass, so you'll get it on there. Mm-hmm. You'll be able to play it anywhere.
I know. I love this because the retail price of this is $20. I mean, which is a very fair price. Is it 30? I thought it was 20.
Well, at least I bought it for 30.
So. Oh, okay.
the digital version.
I just think that getting that as part of Game Pass, along with any other games, so I think Halo 6 will also be part of Game Pass.
Oh, yeah.
So
yeah, there's so many games.
I'm gonna get my money's worth for sure this year.
Easy. Cool. Well, thank you for playing.
That was fun. I'm really glad that everyone was patient with the fact that I don't talk a lot when I game. This is actually way more than I normally talk when I game. Thank you, Adam, for filling in the dead air.
That's why I'm here. You know, I am great at blabbing my mouth, so.
Together by our powers combined.
There we go. Boom. Now we need Purell on her.
Well,
I'm just kidding.
It's too late. No, you gotta do it for like 20 seconds. Yeah, wait till it's completely dry.
1001.
All right, here we go.
1002. Yeah. 1003.
We gotta sing. So, have you seen all the different like lyric things that have come up?
But there's so many lyrics.
But I don't think some of them are accurate because I think one of them.
There's definitely jokes out
there.
There
are some of them that are just jokes because I think one of them was like the chorus from Britney Spears song, and there's no way that takes 20 seconds.
I just always think of that part in The Office when he does the CPR and he's like, oh yeah, just do it to the tune of Staying Alive. Yeah, he's like,
no, it's actually true.
I was afraid, I was petrified. Yeah, and he's like, no,
it's the chorus.
yeah. Anyway, this was fun. More game streams coming up, you know, because it's a quiet time hardware wise. We might as well play some video games on all this hardware that we do have. And thank you, everybody.
Thanks for tuning in.
Will be a full nerd next week. I believe I need to confirm, probably looking at Monday. So mark it on your calendars. Mm-hmm. And the rest of this week, probably not another stream. I have another project. I'm working on my Last Game Standing, my smartphone camera shootout that'll be on Tech Advisor if you want to see that.
Next week, are we going to do anything build related or is that going to be 2 weeks from
probably.
Now?
Probably. I don't know. We need to figure it out.
Yeah. There's a lot up in the air.
We actually had something planned today, but yeah, there's a lot in the air, a lot of figuring out what we're going to do on lockdown and figuring that stuff out. So anyway, why don't you say bye to the fine folks and I will go hit the off switch.
Thanks everyone for tuning in. Appreciate it. We will catch you again soon. I have to wait for Adam to turn off the stream.